Yeah, good morning. Sorry, good evening. We are from SUS Embedded. Okay, the project title name stands for voice based alert system for the blind people. Okay, so in this project, first we are using some sensors. Those are the sensors are called the PIR sensor, and here we used this is called as a stick. Okay, so we fixed it. Actually, it stands for the human body. It can go for blind person. It is going on the road. In front, we are using one front sensor. At the left sensor, we are using one right sensor. These three are sensors are called the stick in ground side. If there is any obstacles or the stones, if they detect that, they give you the sounds called the front obstacle, right obstacle, or the left obstacle. We are stored under the APN9600 voice recorder and playback. All the information is stored in this, and the microcontroller will trip the voice to the APN, give the information to the APN96, and the loudspeaker will be on. And first of all, we'll go for the power supply section. In this power supply, we used 9 volts with 750 milliamps current. So I given two. One is called the transformer. Another one is given called the battery backup. It is 12 volts with 1.3 amps current. Okay, both together it can work it, no problem. It is so I connected to the GPS directly. So if you want to remove those pins, we can remove these pins. Otherwise, we can directly connect it. So most probably you can't connect these pins. Why? Because they will give GPS a large amount of current will be taking. So that's why the battery should be discharged. Better to if you required, you can connect. Otherwise, if you don't have doing the project, you can remove this power supply. And the first of all, we'll give the power supply to this one called the bridge rectifier. In front, we need to give the power supply. Otherwise, you can give the transformer also. In that, the transformer AC power supply, and AC it is converted into the DC called the bridge rectifier. Okay, you can put it. This is called the 2-pin relement cable. So first of all, this is the bridge rectifier, filter capacitor, 7805 regulator, and the LED. The entire section is transferred the power supply section. Okay, if the LED is LED is glowing, call the power is perfectly working. Otherwise, if LED is not glowing, means something should be started in the kit. After that, this is called, here we used 8089S52 microcontroller and 8 bit microcontroller. So it can send the data, receive the data in the form of 8 bits. And the port 0 is connected to the 16x2 LCD display. Total 40 pin IC, 4 ports, port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3. So port 0 is connected to the 16x2 LCD display, 16 characters, 2 line LCD display, liquid crystal display, phosphorus liquid coated display, actual name is, okay. So entire the data in the form of character oriented display is alphanumeric numbers, okay. Whatever the process is going on in this microcontroller, that should be displayed onto the LCD. And the second one is here the port 2. In port 1 cap 3 we are using called the vibration motor. If the human body is detected, then they give the vibration. At the same time, they give the alert to the called the voice output is the speaker to the blind person. And after that, port 3 is connected to the MAX232. MAX232 will receive the data from the GPS, okay. And this is called the RS232 cable. Actual MAX stands for Maxima 232. It's a recommended standard, okay. Level converter, voltage level adjustment purpose, we are using the MAX232 IC. Here we are using the GPS. It's a 65 channel GPS, and it will track the accurate data. This is called inbuilt antenna, okay. 9600 baud rate, the fixed. It's a fixed baud rate, manufactured design like that. It's a Progen module actually, and this is RS232, recommended standard 232. It can send the data, receive the data in the form of packets, okay. So there is no clock cycles, and black wire is called the received, and brown is called ground, red is called TX. There is no sending the data, we can only the capture the data, okay. That is connected with the MAX of port 3 cap 0 and 3 cap 1. And this is called the reset, 9th pin, active high reset, okay. If the data is not getting perfect, we need to restart the kit. and this is the 11.05 into crystal. Crystal is the heart of the circuit for the microcontroller. It will continuously generate the clock pulses to the internal CPU, and the total entire process is taking to the CPU, the crystal. Okay, so here I used one transistor, BC547 transistor, NPN transistor. It is mainly for the to drive the DC motors, called the drive. It is act as a driver IC, so sufficient power purpose. Okay, after that I used one PI sensor, pyroelectric infrared sensor. It can detect motion body, human heat radiation it will absorb. Okay, live body. So if there is in front any human body is detected, then the detector has the live body is detected in front, called around the 5 meters to 6 meters distance. Okay, and after that I am using one obstacle sensors, and white color is transmitter, black is called a receiver, and this is called the blue and white is called the potentiometer, that is called adjustable set point. So how much the distance I need to take from the data from the obstacle. And here I used one transistor, that is BC547 transistor. Whenever the obstacle is coming, the transistor is tip the microcontroller, called maybe high or low. So we designed three, called front, left and right. These are connected to this wire. That wire is connected to the P2 cap. Front left sensor is connected to the P2 cap 0. Front sensor is connected to the P2 cap 1, and back sensor, right sensor is connected to the P2 cap 2, 0, 1, 2, and this is connected with P2 cap 0, 1, 2 and P2 cap 3. Okay, so total the port of P2 cap 0, P2 cap 1, P2 cap 2, these are the sensors, and the output whatever we are coming from the 4 sensors output, that is called right left P2 cap 4, here the P2 cap 4, P2 cap 5, P2 cap 6, P2 cap 4, P2 cap 7. So total entire port is connected to the P2 sensors as well as the data lines. Here APR 9600 is called voice recorder and pay block IC. This voice recorder pay block IC, how it's operates means, machine should first of all we need to give the power supply. Okay, so after whenever we are giving the power supply, so machine should we need to remove the microcontroller, remove the microcontroller. So you don't remove the microcontroller first. I am removing the microcontroller. Okay, why? Because I am removing means how to store the data onto the microcontroller. If I giving the direct microcontroller, then it can't store the data. So if I want to store the data, so this is called the power supply section. So this is called the positive and the negative. Okay, na? So positive and the negative. So I need to store the data. So I need to take one jumper. That jumper is stands for the we need to store the data. So first we need to put it these pins, called the LED will be glow. See that? Okay, LED will go. If I want to store the data onto this one. So this wire is called the ground wire. So this is the external wire I'm giving. So I want to store the data. So first pin that is called the left obstacle. So I want to tell you that left obstacle. So it stored 2 seconds only. This is called front obstacle. Okay. And after that I am giving, this is called the back up, the right. And this is called the fourth one is called the live human body. So entire the data will be stored. Okay, if I want to play it, I need to remove this one. So it will put it this one. So I want to play back it. Okay, see first one. Listen it is. So after that right front. So after that. After that, right. So last one is called the live human body.
Live human body.
Okay. So this is the entire process. So that process, whole process is stored onto the APR 9600. So the whatever the obstacle is coming, they will load it. Okay.